Hello friends, welcome to the Vet Science 360 YouTube channel, and we are discussing the different topics in veterinary medicine, and we have already posted some lectures on veterinary medicine, and today we start discussing about the diseases of the gastrointestinal tract. And the very first disease that we discuss is simple indigestion, right? So if you have already subscribed to my channel, I am highly thankful to you. If you have not already subscribed, kindly do subscribe to my channel, turn on the notifications and hit the subscribe button so that you receive the notification of our videos very fast, right? So let us start the first lecture, that is the first disease of the gastrointestinal tract of cattle and buffalo, and to some extent sheep, that is simple indigestion. Simple indigestion is common in dairy cattle and stall fed beef cattle as well. The etiology is excessive consumption of feed or sudden change in the feed. Simple indigestion is usually associated with a sudden change in the pH of the ruminal contents, such as decrease in the ruminal pH due to rapid fermentation of indigested carbohydrates, or an increase in the ruminal pH due to forced stomach hypomotility and putrefaction of the ingested feed. So suddenly when the farmer changes the feed, he may change the fodder, and suddenly when he changes, then that may lead to simple indigestion. So you can advise the animal owners not to change the feed suddenly, right? If he wants to change a certain feed, say oil cakes, he want to replace a certain type of oil cake with another type of oil cake, he should add slowly and slowly replace it in the diet of the animal, right? Sudden changes will always lead to simple indigestion, right? Now, what are the clinical findings in simple indigestion? There is a drop in the appetite. The animal is consuming less amount of feed. There is fall in the milk yield, and rumination decreases, or sometimes it ceases. The rumen is firm, duffy, but there are no systemic signs. The animal has no fever. It has no other problem. There is no pain on palpation of the animal. So these are the clinical findings in simple indigestion, right? The diagnosis is very simple. A history of change in the appetite is a diagnostic clue, and there is decrease in appetite and forced stomach motility. There is abnormal rumen pH greater than 6 or 7 in multiple animals, right? If a animal owner is having a herd, there will be change in the rumen pH in multiple animals, and of course there is a history of dietary change, and the rumen on palpation is firm and duffy. The primary contractions are decreased in rate or are absent. The temperature, pulse, respiration, all other things are normal. The feces are normal to firm in consistency, but reduced in amount. The recovery usually occurs spontaneously within 24 to 48 hours, but owners may require some treatment, some attention on your part. So what will be the treatment? Withholding the food and for a few hours, and the disease will resolve spontaneously. Magnesium hydroxide 100 to 300 gram can be used as an antacid, and ruminal motility stimulants can be given to improve the motility of the rumen so that the animal regains its appetite, right? The administration of warm water or saline, that is suggested by many textbooks, 0.9% sodium chloride solution, 20 liters orally as a drench or with the stomach tube once, followed by vigorous kneading of the rumen, may help in restoration of the rumen function in adult cattle. Then commercially available products like mild laxatives, an antacid rumen bolus, or products containing the minerals and probiotics and yeast like rumen FS may be given to cattle, and then other products like Rumi Care and buff zone, which improve the rumen function, or the products containing probiotics, amino acids and liver extract like BioBoost can also be administered to the animals to improve their appetite, to improve their rumen motility. And products, the herbal products like Himalayan Batisa, etc., may be advised to the animal owners to be given as a placebo, because if the feed is withheld for some hours, then rumen motility will regain spontaneously. But if too much of feed has been consumed by the animal, then it may take some time in restoration of the rumen motility. No need to administer any antibiotics, no need to administer anything else. The only things that are required are some probiotics or maybe yeast or ruminal motility stimulators that are required for regaining the normal function of the rumen, right? So need not to worry. It's very common. It's a very common case which clinicians often face, and maybe questions are not asked in your exam, but as a clinician, this is the most common case of affecting the gastrointestinal tract of cattle, which clinicians often face in their clinics, right? So here is my email, my Instagram link. You can contact me at my email, and then kindly, if you like this video, kindly share it, kindly give your likes, give your comments, share with your friends, give your suggestions also. And if you want that I should bring more and more videos, lectures in veterinary medicine, then kindly do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. Then we have started a new app, the GNP Sir Classes app. You can find many courses there for field vets, for veterinary students, for aspirants of competitive exams like GRF, and for aspirants appearing for any interview. So kindly visit our GNP Sir Classes app, download it, and we have a lot of free material uploaded in the app. You can download it, you can read it, and you can do the way you like. So have a nice time. Kindly do subscribe to my channel. Once again, I am requesting you, kindly do subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye-bye. Have a nice time. Bye-bye.